Signature TV News Updates. I am Ifunanya Ilodianya. And the headlines. Nigerians react to bill to appoint persons with disability into the Federal Executive Council. Umahi visits Chief of Army Staff, pledges support for war against insecurity. National Primary Health Care Development Agency says over 600,000 Nigerians have received the second dose of the COVID-19 vaccination. And now the details. A bill seeking appointment of young persons and persons living with disability has been introduced in the Nigeria's House of Representatives. The bill titled Yes We Can would compel the president to appoint young persons and those living with disabilities as ministers and members of the board of government agencies and parastatals. What are the reactions of Nigerians to this bill? Signature TV correspondent Chibweze Obi got the views of some Abuja residents.
If these disabled people are able to carry out their duty in any position impounded on them, there are some disabled people that actually in this our country, they still make it big, they still go out. There are people who have legs, one legs, two legs, one hand, they still go out and they still make daily ends. But there are people who doesn't have legs and hands. I think those people who doesn't have legs and hand, they don't have anything to contribute in the politics. The only thing they have to do is, one, they have their ideas and their opinions to render. And outside that one, I think such people should be given a benefit or a grant.
Well, I'm in support of that development because I think we need people who are competent, and I think it has to do with more of competence and integrity. So if we have disabled persons who are competent to deliver, who have the capacity mentally and they can deliver at a given task, then it's a welcome development.
They are human beings who have anticipation and who have problems to solve. And they should not be allowed into the wayward environment to go as constituting nuisances. Are you hearing me? So the House of Reps, having come up with that such a bill, is an applaud to them. Are you getting me? So I support such a bill.
We do things in this country now that make these people who are disabled feel they didn't belong. That make them to feel their right is being denied. If they are included, it's a welcome idea and I'm fully in support of it.
The governor of Ebonyi State, Engineer David Umahi, on Tuesday paid a courtesy visit to the Army Chief of Staff and pledged his support to end insecurity across the country. Signature TV correspondent Chibweze Obi was at the events and now reports.
The governor said his visit was to congratulate the Army Chief on his appointment and to encourage him in his renewed efforts and dedication in eradicating the insecurity bedeviling the country.
Congratulate you and to encourage you and your team in the task of repositioning our nation security-wise. We continue to encourage those who stand out for the unity of the country. Let me say that in this trying period of insecurity, that the Army has tremendously done very well. And a lot of them have also paid the supreme sacrifice to ensure that we are safe. So this thing we must appreciate, this thing we must encourage them. Because it's not easy for somebody to be awake while you're sleeping. We pledge total support and commitment to the ongoing programs in the Northeast and all over the country.
Umahi stated that some soldiers have lost their lives in their quest to keep the country united, and praised those that have committed themselves to defend and keep the country as one. He advised the Army Chief not to allow politics in the military, adding that the bond of unity should be strengthened among the military for effective service delivery.
There is a need not to bring politics into our security architecture. This is very important. Let the bond of oneness and unity amongst the army is strengthened so that they will continue to show very good example to the rest of the armed forces.
The Chief of Army Staff, Major General Farouk Yahaya, appreciated the governor for his effort and support in restoring peace in Ebonyi State, while stating that dialogue cannot work in an atmosphere of chaos.
Prepare you to further support our efforts bringing peace and security to that zone. It's only with peace and security that all other developments, all other agitations, all other requirements, you know, can be looked into. When everything is peaceful, then there is nothing that we cannot sit down and negotiate and dialogue. But we cannot dialogue and negotiate when in the atmosphere of chaos and fight.
The courtesy visit, which was the first meeting with the new Chief of Army Staff, was to strengthen the relationship between the Army and the Ebonyi State, as well as renewing collaboration in the fight against insecurity in the country. In Abuja, Chibwezobi for Signature TV.
The Executive Director of the National Primary Healthcare Development Agency, Dr. Faisal Shoaib, at a press briefing on Tuesday said over 680,000 Nigerians have received the second dose of the COVID-19 vaccination since the beginning of the second phase of the vaccine administration campaign across the country. He urged Nigerians who have taken the first dose to go for the second dose and encourage all Nigerians to get vaccinated. Blessing Adejo was at the events and now reports.
We have now held town hall meetings in North Central and North East zones across our country, while efforts to ensure supply of safe and effective COVID-19 vaccines in Nigeria are ongoing. The Presidential Steering Committee this week will be having our planned South-South Zonal Town Hall meeting with stakeholders and the larger communities on COVID-19 vaccination in Benin at the Edo State capital. We are fully committed to going to communities to discuss directly with our to discuss directly our vaccine efforts, the importance of staying safe and protected against COVID-19, and answering questions people have. We have been really grateful for the high levels of participation and interest in these events. We are confident that through continued awareness raising, we'll be able to keep communities safe and healthy. I therefore urge all Nigerians who have received their first dose at least 6 weeks ago to visit the nearest vaccination site to receive their second dose for the full protection against COVID-19 on or before June the 25th.
The chairman of the Nigeria Labour Congress NLC in Cross River State, Comrade Ben Opebi, has been released by his abductors after 82 days in captivity. Opebi was abducted on Sunday, March 21, 2021, in front of his house at the Crossfield Estate in Akpabio, local government area of Cross River State, as his Cross River State chapter of NLC was planning a strike action over pending labor issues. Police spokesperson in the state, ASP Irene Ugbo Opebi, confirmed on Tuesday that he was released on Monday, June 14th, with no information given on how Ben Opebi was released or whether a ransom was paid or not. This was the second time Opebi has been kidnapped. It was double tragedy for a corpse on Tuesday morning as an ambulance conveying it crashed into a stationary truck. The crash, which involved the corpse being conveyed to an unknown destination, allegedly occurred at about 8:30 a.m. along the Benin-Lagos Highway close to Okada Junction, Ovia Northeast Local Government Area of Edo State. Some mourners in the motorcade for the burial sustained varying degrees of injuries. An eyewitness who craved anonymity told newsmen that the crash resulted in a traffic built-up, leaving Lagos-bound travelers and other road users stranded for hours. Officials of the Federal Road Safety Corps, SignatureTV learned, promptly evacuated the victims and took them to the hospital for medical attention. Nigerians have applauded the bravery of a 14-year-old girl who reported her father to the police for sexually abusing her According to the Lagos State Police Command, the girls stormed their station to demand the arrest of her 45-year-old father, one Kayode Adeyaju. The teen disclosed to the police that the father had been defiling her on that fateful day. He made attempts to abuse her again, but however, she escaped. And while she was on her way to church, she personally marched to the police. The Commissioner of Police, Lagos State Commissioner Hakim Odumosu, has condemned the acts and ordered that the case be transferred to the gender unit of the command for further investigation. In business, Nigeria has started repaying loans borrowed from China. According to Rotimi Amaechi, the Minister of Transportation, the federal government was looking for Chinese lenders to help fund a number of infrastructure projects, including standard gauge rail lines. Nigeria's overall borrowing from China, according to the Debt Management Office, was $3.12 billion as of 31st of March 2020. Nigeria has never defaulted on loans from other countries or international lenders, Amaechi claimed in an interview with Arise on Monday. The ministry stated that the President Goodluck Jonathan's administration received $500 million from China, but just $150 million was refunded. According to Amaechi, the loan for the Ibadan-Kano rail is about $1.5 billion, with the remaining $500 million coming from their budget, as he strongly believes that whatever loan they take, they will be able to repay. Let's join Brenda Ita for entertainment news.
Thank you, Ifunanya. Hello, good evening. Thanks for joining us in entertainment news. I am Brenda Ita. Singer Wizkid, also known as Big Wiz, is celebrating the 10th anniversary of the release of his debut album, Superstar. For this, the Grammy Award-winning star has dropped a documentary titled A Superstar Made in Lagos, which was released on Saturday, June 12, 2021. In the main video, Big Wiz offers some insight into his life, love, and music career so far. In the documentary, several of the Don't Dull singer's friends and mentors, including Femi Kuti, Anthony Joshua, Banky W, and more, shared their thoughts about the singer. Popular entertainer Denrele Edun has been surprised with a brand new Lexus SUV for his 40th birthday. The eccentric media personality clocked 40 on Sunday, June 13, 2021, and was treated to a grand surprise by his ride-or-die friends. The media personality took to his Instagram page to share the video, showing the moment he was led to the park where the brand new car laced with ribbons had been parked. In his caption, Denrele acknowledged his loyal friends for all the wonderful surprises he received, noting that his 40th birthday celebration left him absolutely stupefied. That's all we have for you today on entertainment news. Till I come your way again next time, do have a wonderful evening. Brenda Ita.
In the world of sports, Sunday Olise has praised the Super Falcons for their fight back, which saw them force Portugal to a 3-3 draw in their second game of the Four Nations Summer Series. A stoppage time goal by Rashidat Ajibade saw the Falcons hold the Portuguese to a draw. The European raced to 2-0 before the Falcons reduced the deficit late in the first half and early in the second half. Portugal went 3-1 before the Falcons lifted themselves back to the game, scoring two goals. Reacting to the game, Olise wrote on his verified Twitter handle, "Don't you just love the change in pace, Niger style? Great comeback." The Falcons will take on the host USA in their final game of the tournament on Thursday, June 17th at 2 a.m. Nigerian time. Nigerians have reacted to a bill to appoint persons with disability into the Federal Executive Council. Some who spoke to SignatureTV says it's a welcome development. Governor of Ebonyi State David Umahi on Tuesday visited Chief of Army Staff, where he advised him not to allow politics into the military. An ambulance conveying a corpse has been involved in an accident in Edo State, with some mourners sustaining injuries. This is the Signature TV News Update. On behalf of my producer, Damilola Abudu, I am Ifunanya Ilodianya. Thanks for watching.